Hello guys and welcome back to a new video. Today I'm with the new Nissan Qashqai 2022 version and we will do the test drive. And yeah, I'm really curious to see how it is to drive this new Nissan Qashqai because I hear so many good things about the car. I hear the improvements are big and I'm really curious. Today we will drive the car. By the way, before we start driving the car, I want to give you the technical data and to tell you a few things about the car, to tell you which model and which version I have with me right here. Of course, I will have on my channel another video with full review. If you want to see the review with the car, interior, exterior, all the detail about the car, material quality, space and all that stuff, you will find it on my channel probably soon. If it's not already there, just click the subscribe button to see the notification when that video will come out. But until then guys, I want to tell you that I'm here at Autohaus Hart in Switzerland in Langenthal. I will leave the link in the description if you want to buy the car, if you want to see the car, if you want to test drive the car, just check them out. Also, the price of the car right here, it's 41,200 francs. But guys, call them, tell them you see my videos, you come from me and you will get a discount. So yeah, give them a try. Also guys, I want to tell you that the model that I have with me, it's the 1.3 liter DIGT petrol engine with a mild hybrid 12 volt. Battery system. Also, I will explain you a little bit as we go how this mild hybrid system work. I'll give you more information. Also, the CO2 emission of the car with this engine, it's 150 grams. The consumption 6.7 liters. It's the average consumption. I want to give you also a little bit more details about the car. For example, the car come with McPherson suspension in the front. Also on the rear, it has torsion beam semi-independent suspension. On the four-wheel drive version, because here with me is the two-wheel drive version, the front-wheel drive version, it comes with this torsion beam suspension semi-independent in the back. But if you get the four-wheel drive version, you will have better suspension, multi-link. It's a little bit more complex but a little bit better suspension. The turning circle of the car, 11.1 meters. The trunk space and all that stuff you will find out in the review video, but I still want to tell you that the car can do 0 to 100 km in 9.2 seconds. And the petrol engine comes with four cylinders in line, comes with this new automatic transmission X-tronic from Nissan. It's a really good transmission. The maximum speed of the car, 200 kilometers, and I think those are the most important data before we start the video. Also, before we start driving, click the subscribe button and yeah, let's do it guys. Let's drive the car. Let's see how it's handling on the street. All right guys, so here is the car. By the way, this is the key guys. It's super light and small key, nothing crazy, nothing fancy, and also it's incredible light and small, like my finger. Of course, you can lock the car from here. It comes with electronic folding mirrors. I don't know why they are not working right now. And also it comes with lock and unlock button right here. You can lock and unlock the car by putting your finger right here, just like that. Super, super simple. Also, it comes with folding mirrors. You can fold it from here. Just press this button. You can see right now they are folding in, and also you can fold it out from the interior. I think it's a setting is in the menu that is not activated yet. And of course, the trunk right here in this version, it's manual adjustable, so you don't have an automatic lift gate. But all about that guys, check out my other video. I will have another separate video with a full review. There you find all the information about the car, interior, exterior, the trunk space, the space in the back, the material quality. We talk a little bit about the glass roof, that it's gorgeous. I mean, I love this glass roof. I love how much light it is inside the car. It's just incredible. Now let me go inside guys. I have to tell you that right here we don't have electronic adjustable seats. We have manual adjustable seats, but it's quite okay. You can adjust it in the position, in the perfect position. You have a tall driving position. What I noticed from the previous version is that the car inside this new Qashqai, you have better visibility. The A pillar, it's smaller, so you have a perfect visibility. Also, the mirrors are a little bit closer to you. They are on the door right now, and you have amazing visibility. I mean, the visibility right now in the mirrors around the windows. You have a big windshield in the front that it's extended a little bit more here. It's just incredible. The visibility and how much light come inside the car is just perfect. And also in the back there you can see a bigger window, really big window. Even here in this mirror you have great visibility. I like that very much, to be honest. Also I like the steering wheel very much. Leather, great quality steering wheel. Kind of keep the same buttons and design, but it's a great steering wheel. Also the Nissan logo is nice. And yeah, the new gear shifter in the middle look gorgeous, but all about that I explain later. Here you have the driving modes. Let's press the brake. Let's start the engine. Here is the start engine button right here. Interesting where they place it. Usually it should be around here. Also it comes with a new digital cockpit that looks just gorgeous, guys. I take you through a little bit faster just like that, but I explain, I have a separate video about that where you can find more infos about that. Also let's reset this. Reset, yes, go back, and we will see what will be the consumption after our trip. It's lovely. I mean, this big, I think it's 12-inch display, digital display, is just lovely. And also the head-up display, I don't know if you can see it, is directly on the windshield. Great resolution, great colors. You have such a good visibility on the head-up display and on the cockpit. It's a big steering wheel, perfect visibility. Also the multimedia system, it's here in the middle. It looks a little bit the same as the previous one, but it's much more responsive when you touch it. And yeah, it's positioned quite good, so you have good visibility. I think they can improve a little bit more the design of the multimedia, but other than that, it's just perfect. Here you have the climatic system in glossy plastic, and also the buttons are glossy plastic. It looks gorgeous. The car come with heated seats, heated steering wheel, heated windshield. The windshield is heated for the winter, is perfect. I like very much the fact that the car come with electronic handbrake and auto hold. You have the buttons here, and different driving modes, because this is only front wheel drive. You have only three different driving modes. The all wheel drive you will have also off-road and raining or stuff like that, I don't remember exactly. But here you have sport, standard and eco. We will try all. We will start in eco mode first of all, and then we will go forward. We will see how it's handling the car. You can change from here the driving modes. I like very much also this gear shifter. It's so nice, it's so cool. Going in reverse, the car come with 360 degrees camera. You can press this camera button here and you can see what it's around the car. It's really interesting, cool feature. And then also going in drive, and then if you go one more time in the back, you will see drive S, like sport mode or drive normal. And then the parking button is up here on this nice shifter. I like very much the shifter. I like this center console. Now let's drive, guys, because I will explain in another video a little bit more about that. Going in reverse, and right now because the auto hold it's working, you just press the acceleration and the car will move. Also it's very easy to park the car. It's incredible easy. It's also what I noticed, it's very much more precise, the steering wheel. It's much better quality. They improved the steering wheel. Going in drive, I don't know how can I explain you, it's better feedback from the steering wheel. This is the word, guys, the feedback. The feedback of the steering wheel is much better. It feels soft and nice to drive. It feels much more agile, to be honest. And also if you want to turn the car in small spaces, turn left after 100 meters. Let's try to turn around here. Let's try the turning radius. It's 11.1 meter, guys. And if for example you want to turn it around here, you can see you can turn it even in small spaces. That's why so many people bought this car for the first time, because they Nissan come with this idea of crossover SUV that can be driving without any problem in the city, and also on the highway. And you have also that safety and that tall driving position. I like very much this tall driving position. I have such a good visibility from here. Gorgeous visibility from the upper side right here. It's just incredible. I love this driving position. This tall driving position is just lovely. Lovely, guys. Now I like very much also the head-up display. I think it's one of the best head-up display that I have seen on the car today. Of course, not taking into consideration the Mercedes S-Class, that it's over 150,000. The head-up display is just
perfect. Also the new cockpit, you have gorgeous visibility in the cockpit. You have also very good visibility around the windows, as I said before. First impression when we start driving is that the noise insulation, it's very good. You cannot hear so much noise from outside, so it's relatively smooth. You can see the people working here, and it's incredible silent inside the car. I like that very much, to be honest. Also, it's really easy to maneuver on the small streets like this. The AC, it's on right now. And also, to be honest, what I notice is that the engine, it's silent. It's not so loud. Of course, it's a petrol engine, so we cannot expect to be very loud, but it's incredible silent, and that's a good thing. That's a very good thing. Also, the car can read the traffic speed limit. It comes with the latest technology in terms of autopilot. I think it calls Pilot Pro 2, and they improve from the previous version, from the previous cars. They improve this autopilot, so you can cruise control, use the cruise control, and the car will keep the distance for you. The car will go to a stop, and then if it's not longer than 3 seconds, it will also accelerate automatically. It comes with also safety features, blind spot technology, emergency brake, and all that safety features that Nissan come on the other models as well. Also, it's very agile here on the roundabout as well. I like it. I like how the car it's feeling. It feels really premium when you drive it. And also, you have a very good driving position on those seats. I will also talk a little bit about those seats in the review, so check out the other video review. There I talk about the seats. Very, very good position of driving, and they are very comfortable. I think many people will love the driving position of the car. It's so tall and so straight away. And for the people that struggle with driving, and they really want to have a perfect driving position, I think this car is just genius. I mean, I have such a good driving position. The windshield, it's big mirrors, big windows on the side. I have perfect position, also good visibility here. It's just everything you need. I mean, it's easy to drive. The steering, it's incredible assisted and softy. The car, it feels really, really light, you know. And I know, I read about the car before, and Nissan said that the doors, the hood and the fender are made by aluminium, and also the trunk door, it's made by somehow a plastic, and they save around 60 kilograms, and the car is much more lighter, much more agile. They also save some light on other stuff, and I'm really impressed with what they did. It's lovely feeling. Also here over the bumps, let's see. Yeah, lovely. You don't even feel the bumps. They also changed the suspension from the previous version, so right now they have McPherson suspension in the front, independent, as I said before, also in the rear. On this version right here, we have torsion beam semi-independent suspension, and they are really good. It's so smooth, you don't even feel with what speed you are driving. I mean, even right now, it's lovely. It's like you're floating. Very good suspensions. Let's change the driving mode from down here. It's very easy. You don't even have to look, because you have this physical button and you change it like that. You go in standard mode. In standard mode, I can already feel the acceleration is a little bit more aggressive. And The steering, it's very similar. I think it's the same. Steering wheel didn't change too much now in standard mode. Just the acceleration and the way it's changing the gears. I like also this X-tronic transmission from Nissan. I think it's one of the best one and one of the most reliable. And the car in general, it's one of the most reliable car. The Japanese people, and they did always a great job with the car, and I really trust this car, to be honest. The system, the mechanical parts, they are trustworthy. Lovely smooth. I like how smooth the car it is. It's really also on the curves, you're really feeling like you're in a comfortable premium car. And 40,000 francs for this car, I think it's a great price. I mean, an SUV, I don't remember last time when I review an SUV under 40,000 francs, so good. And it's a brand new car, a lot of features. Right now, let me activate this cruise control, guys. Also, you have a button here, steering on, and then you can set the speed. For example, right now, let me set it, just cruise to, yeah, let's say, and look at this. Right now you can see the steering wheel right there. I don't know if you can see it on the head-up display, but the car will keep the steering wheel, will keep between the lanes, will accelerate for you, it give you a warning, put your hand on the steering wheel. I like very much the graphics. The graphics are incredible nice, and look at this, it stay between the lanes. This is the ProPilot level 2 or ProPilot 2. It's really good. Also, it's warn you, put your hands here, and it's also, look at this, it's reading, he knows it's a roundabout in front, and it's also slowing down for me. Wow, that it used this map, you know, like the newest car on the market. I see that also on the Mercedes, on the Volkswagen, I think, if I remember well. Also sad, and many manufacturers today use this how they call it, they use this a map, the navigation map, to anticipate what comes next. For example, if it comes a roundabout, the car will automatically brake for you guys, and he will reach the speed that it will see on the traffic signs. For example, if it's 60 here, the car will slow down. If it's 80, the car will accelerate, it will go to 80. So you don't have to do manually, you know, like I do it in my Tesla Model 3, when I have to do always, if I see there it's 80, oh, okay, go to 80. No, the car will read it. Right now it read it 60, look at this. I don't know if you can see it on the screen there, but it read the speed, look at this, 60. It read the speed, and it's automatically downside the speed to 60, or if it see 80, it's automatically go to 80. And yeah, I can see right now it's also holding the lanes for me, and it's doing a good job. Right now it's, look at this, it's brake for me. Yeah, it's incredible. It's a great system. This ProPilot 2, it's a really good system that I like it, and I like very much the graphics. The graphics are really good, and the head-up display, it's incredible nice. Great graphics on the head-up display. I love the way it looks. And yeah, what can I say, guys? Great safety features on the 40,000 francs price for an SUV that big. And look at the review there, you can see more information about the car. Let me go to sport mode right now. I take the control, and let's, all right, it has a little bit of punch. 158 horsepower is more than enough, so you have that power when you accelerate. I like it, I like the way it feels. Also right now it will go to higher RPM, so we will change the gears a little bit later, and I think you can have some fun with the car. The steering, it's I think the same, doesn't change too much, maybe a little bit stiffer, but in general I don't feel a big difference in terms of steering wheel when I change the driving modes. I think it's just the driving modes are just made for the transmission, for the X-tronic transmission. I don't think it is also for other things. Yeah, it has a little bit of delay here, it has a little bit of delay when you accelerate, but it's relatively good, relatively fine. The wipers are perfect. I love the fact that the car comes with a heated windshield, heated steering wheel, heated seats. Lovely features on the car. Also, it comes with the latest technology in terms of lights in the nighttime. You have LED lights. You have also possibility to connect to the Android Auto, Apple CarPlay. You have the internet connectivity. I like how simple it is. Ah, by the way, you have those pedals behind the steering wheel where you can change the speed manual if you want to have some fun. Also, right now we are with the gear shifter in DS, I mean drive sport, because we are in sport mode. And yeah, what can I say? I like it. I like the car. Auto hold right now. I don't have to hold my foot on the brake, for example. It's nice. I like it. I like the car, to be honest. Right now you can set the car, look at it, at 60, and the car will keep the distance between me and the car in front. It will accelerate, it will brake. This is the cruise control. It's lovely. I mean, it's a must have it, because it take off your stress, take off your lovely. I like it. I like the power. You immediately feel that power when you press the acceleration. Oh yeah. And surprisingly, guys, what surprised me the most on this Qashqai is the fact that it's an SUV, but it feels really agile, man. I mean, it's so light. Even if I brake around, look at this, even if you brake, it's crazy. It doesn't feel like you're heavy and it push you forward. And when I'm sitting inside the car, I feel like I'm in a bigger SUV, like I'm in a I don't know, X7 or something really big. It's really, really, it feels like you are in a huge SUV, like Q7 or X7 or I don't know. It's really, really high position. But the car, it's crazy, crazy light. I like how light it is. It's incredible light. Love it. Love what they did with the car. And it's so soft to drive. Even here, the handlings, the way it stay on the road. I know the Japanese people and Nissan, they make such a good cars. I really trust those cars. I think it will last like many kilometers. Anyway, let's go in eco mode again. Eco mode back, and right now the acceleration is smoother, the car is silent, and the steering wheel it's a little bit more softer, I have to say that. And the great part is that the car doesn't feel like a boat, you know. You don't feel like a boat when you take the curves. It feels really stable. It's a great combination of suspension. Yeah, they said they improved the suspension, and now I trust them. I believe them, because it really, really feel really good. The suspension for the car, it's gorgeous, and the car, it stay lovely on the street. Right now, take those curves. It's agile, it's easy to drive in small spaces. Even though it's such a big car, it feels so agile. Going in reverse, and you can park the car without any problem. Even though if you look in the mirrors, you have such a big, huge mirrors, so you can park the car without any problem. Press the brake, stop the wipers, and then stop the engine. Right now, gorgeous. The consumption was 8.6. Liters, gorgeous consumption, man. I like that. For the way I drive, it's just update complete, the best. I had the best consumption, 8.6 until now. Gorgeous. I love this digital cockpit. If you want to see the cockpit, if you want to see the multimedia system, I will have a special video, check out on my channel. Also, the head-up display, by the way, because I close it right now, I don't know if you see it before, the head-up display, guys, look at this, it's just incredible nice. I will explain you a little bit more also in the review video about it, but I love the car. I mean, the way it drives, it's a big improvement from the previous version. I have to tell you guys, big improvement. I think the comfort, the steering, direction, and how precise it is, the suspensions, the visibility, it's a big improvement. Also the safety feature, the autopilot, the multimedia system, the gear shifter, everything. It's new, it's nice. Okay, let me give it a rating. Let's take into consideration the fact that the car, it's around 40,000 francs for an SUV with climatic system, automatic climatic system, heated steering wheel, heated seats, heated windshield, glass roof, leather in combination with this fabric material, kind of a plastic here, wireless charging, USB port, driving mode, automatic transmission. The price and the quality and the exterior design, my rating from 1 to 10 will be 9.6. I will give it a 9.6. They still can improve a little bit here and there. The quality in the interior is very similar with what you will find on a Mazda cars. If you know Mazda cars, if you touch those elements here and down here, you have soft material, but it's the same feeling as on the Mazda cars. So great job, Nissan. I like your car very much. I hope you enjoy the test drive, guys. I hope you get some useful information from it. I hope I didn't miss anything, or I hope you can make an idea about it. Also, thank you very much for watching my videos. If you like it, please like it and share it. I will really appreciate that. Also, subscribe to the channel if you want to see the full review with the car, interior, exterior, all the information, and also multimedia system will come soon on the channel. Just click the subscribe button to see the notification when that video will come out. Until next time, don't forget to check out our website, sdadancar.com. There you find a lot of articles, videos about cars and tips about how to buy a car and stuff like that. Also, I will leave the link in the description to the car if you want to buy it. And if you are around Switzerland, just check them out. Autohaus Hart in Langenthal. Also, tell them, call them, come here, tell them you see my video and you want a discount. And they will fit you perfectly. Thank you very much for watching, guys. Stay safe, and until next time, see you guys. Bye.